Now for the 8th of the 11 games recorded with my Switch Online free trial, Journey to Silius. I'd watched maybe one video on this game over a decade ago and didn't remember too much, so this is all new to me. The game stars Jay McRae, the son of a scientist working on Space Colony 428 in a far future where overpopulation of Earth has led to hundreds of these colonies. Jay is about to move to said colony to work with his father when it is destroyed in an explosion, killing everyone on board. Jay finds a floppy disk in his father's room. It contains the colony plans and a message from his father asking Jay to finish work on the colony should the current one be destroyed by terrorists. And so Jay's response is to take on those terrorists for a little bit of vengeance. Stage 1 takes place in front of what I assume is the ruins of the colony. Right away I start with just a normal gun with infinite ammo. Got robots with big eyes hopping towards me, flying drones that fire a spread of 3 shots downwards, lasers popping in and out of the ground, and cannon fire coming from the background. After a bit, a missile launcher also gets added in. And it goes like this for a while with the odd pit in the way. But it's not too hard and I don't take very many hits. Which I don't mind, it lets me focus on enjoying that first level theme more. Sometimes enemies will drop a pink item that recovers a little health. I reach the end of the stage, but there's this big cannon constantly changing heights that I lose most of my health to until I get its pattern down. Killing it makes it drop a machine gun and sends me to the boss, a helicopter. I swap over to a shotgun I picked up. All weapons apart from the handgun have limited ammo. The helicopter drops these aliens that hop around and shoot the odd projectile. The shotgun is a three-way spread. I get killed by one of them, and so in my next life, I try the machine gun and quickly blow through all my ammo. After killing enough aliens, the helicopter then lowers and slowly approaches me while firing its guns. I just have to jump over the shots and keep shooting until it explodes. My health and ammo are refilled and I move on to stage 2. I'm inside a building where the first new enemy are these robots with guns. Moving on, they're joined by turrets that float around and fire several spread shots at once. Further on is a circular turret that fires bullets in a clockwise pattern. Past it, I start descending a few platforms with this one machine that extends upwards a bit but doesn't seem to have another attack. I keep dropping down, usually landing on an enemy and taking damage. Once I reach the bottom, I get moving right again. But one of those cannons from the end of stage 1 manages to kill me. I lose most of my health to it next time, but take it out, which has this lift descent that I then ride to the next floor. I end up a hit from death but slowly inch my way to another lift going up. That's when the next new enemy, this floating metal prawn that launches bullets in freeze in an arc, shows up. But I get past it and the next few enemies until I find this tall bipedal robot. It's easy to avoid and I take it out, it dropping the homing missile and sending me to the boss, a large tank. It fires red orbs in an arc and extends out its massive claw. Its weak point is the glowing spot on its chest. I just have to keep firing while avoiding those projectiles, the claw isn't really a problem, until the chest takes enough hits to be destroyed. Stage 3 has me inside some kind of base with Terminators walking towards me. For anyone who doesn't know yet, this game was intended to be a Terminator game until the license was lost mid-development. We get these spinning hexagonal things speeding by, and then these floating robots followed by glass domes that alternate firing diagonally left and right. The homing missiles and shotgun are good for those. Past a couple of those is a lift going up. There's a spider robot off to the left, but I ignore it and keep moving right past this crusher. Then it's into this cramped tunnel with more crushers and robots bouncing towards me. Once I'm out of the tunnel, there are flamethrowers built into the ground. I then have this blinking laser wall to time a jump through, followed by more crushers and a lift going down. For the first time in the game, I'm moving left and dropping down a few floors while dealing with more domes and spider robots. Once I'm at the bottom, I'm moving right again with my next obstacle being these large weights that drop when I get near, followed by another new kind of flying robot before I reach another drop. But I fall into a spider robot and lose my last life. So it's back through the entire level again. I die again on the way back, right after those weights. Now I'm aware of the enemies, I can safely drop down that shaft. Move right some more past more crushers, more flying robots, and another laser wall until I reach another lift going up. I have a cramped space to deal with more enemies, and then an even more cramped tunnel filled with laser walls before I reach this walking cannon which I fill with homing missiles. I destroy it and it drops a laser for me to pick up. This sends me to the boss, the core of this base. It has several lasers and guns firing everywhere, with the weak point being the glowing orb. But crouching in this spot has you out of every gun's range, meaning it's just a case of timing my jumps and the laser gun correctly. But I had little health at the start, so I lose another life. With full health, I manage to outlast it and take it down. Stage 4 now, and my first new enemy is a flying drone that speeds by. Right away I'm taking a lift down and fighting Terminators with Xenomorph heads. They're followed by a new kind of crusher that moves faster than the ones from the last stage. And then a new hopping robot that I can't think of the visual comparison for. Then comes a rising and lowering stacks of spikes along this pole, floating robots with a three-way spread that also swoop down in an arc, and behind it, another lift going down. To the left a little and dropping down a bit before heading right again. all the while dealing with these little turrets that rise out of the ground when approached. The waves from stage 3 return. I deal with some more enemies and jump some spike pits to find a moving block covered in spikes approaching me. They end up phasing through it thanks to being hit by the enemy. The next chunk of a level is nothing new until I'm jumping pits with falling platforms. Past them is another lift going up. More spikes to avoid within a smaller space and more pits to cross, but then after them is another spike pole that kills me and takes my last life. I lose my first life on that same set of spikes, but luckily I'm checkpointed past them. I have a long wave of the usual enemies until I find a mini-boss, a floating mech with no legs and a machine gun that can only be damaged in the head. It's tough to avoid since I can't jump over it and have to run through with my post-damage invincibility. After enough damage, the body is destroyed, leaving just the head floating around. It has a spread shot now, but I just use my homing missile to destroy it and gain my final weapon, the grenade launcher. Now the boss, a huge alien-looking mech with a massive cannon that I fail to avoid fire from and lose a life to. This time the weak spot only opens right after a cannon shot, so I have to time things perfectly while also avoiding getting shot. I use the grenade launcher for this, which deals huge damage. Huge enough that despite the hits I take, I outdamage it and destroy it with 2 blocks of health left. That just leaves the final stage. We're in what looks like waste disposal, and to make things harder, the game's final level is its only auto-scroller. We have rubbish dropping down from the sky into pits I need to jump over, piss dispensers I need to time my jumps through, conveyors to cross while avoiding the crates of varying size, along with using the larger ones as platforms. Failing to realise that last part gets me a game over when I get crushed by the screen trying to make a jump I can't do alone. I make it through next time and have a room filled with very fast, very wide crushers. I fail to dodge them well enough and lose a life here. Even next time I lose most of my health getting through. More conveyors next, this time with large crates falling into the pits and very thin conveyors that require an immediate jump on landing. That's followed by crushers that move up towards the ceiling as I jump across them. After that are 3 crushers right next to each other, and then some more conveyors until halfway through this one where I'm unceremoniously dumped in front of the boss. Its weak spot is the glass dome at the very front. However, the rocket is always moving while the screen is static, making me need to manoeuvre around it, avoiding exhaust fire and getting myself killed hitting my head on it while jumping. Next time I'm patient enough to just let it pass over me to find another dome on the other side, giving me enough time to destroy it and then wait for the left dome to fly back on screen so I can get rid of that one too. This leads to the final boss, another Terminator, but really tall. It walks towards me while I can only damage it in the face at the height of my jump. Once it gets close enough, it crouches and goes for a punch, giving me the chance to jump over, run to the other side of the screen and repeat the process. I could have maybe killed it faster, but considering I was 2 hits from death on my last life, I was being cautious. I get 2 hits in and wait for the chance to jump. I take 1 hit during this but manage to keep it up until the boss explodes. We see what I assume is the rebuilt colony float off away and then the credits. I think Journey to Silius is good. I've covered better NES games, I've covered worse. It has a great soundtrack and I appreciate that it lacks a lot of the bullshit of older NES games while still being a challenge. Despite that, I find some of the more bullshit games like the Ninja Gaiden and Castlevania games I've looked at more enjoyable, and I don't find this game as memorable as them either. It has no major flaws, but soundtrack aside, I don't think it has any major strengths either. I've been having a tough time in the months since I played this deciding where I'm ranking this one. There's like a range of 30 places it could go, but I am edging towards it being ranked slightly into the top half of the ranking. I'm thinking somewhere in the 80s.